This is a free download from the BBC. For more information, go to bbc.co.uk/podcasts.
Two, two. And the podcast starts now.
One, two.
Okay, guys, I thought welcome to the podcast. It's coming towards the end of series three, season three, we say now. Will there be a season four? Well, we just don't know. What?
Season four is winter.
No, season four is when we get a robot butler or we adopt a child. And season four may or may not begin in September. We just don't know yet.
It traditionally begins in late
Mate,
September.
I'm not talking about literal... come on, guys. This is coming towards the end of my third year. I'm talking about years. Okay?
Wow.
Steady.
That's up 3 years of working with you.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't call it working. I'd call it playing.
Player.
Unless, of course, any solicitors are listening, then I would call it hard work.
Hard
work. Oh, no, take the word hard out. I would call it... Anyway, welcome to the podcast. I thought it would be nice if we went round and introduced ourselves. Name, rank and number. So... My name's Iain Lee. I'm the presenter of The Breakfast Show on BBC Three Counties Radio. Yeah, that's all I've got to say.
I'm Matt. I'm a dog's body, occasional plum.
Occasional.
I'm Paul Scoins. I'm a reporter.
but seriously, who are you?
I'm Paul Scoins. I'm a political reporter.
Okay. You live in your little fantasy world. It's, I mean, it's the internet where dreams can come true. Technically. It's like Second Life. Young lady. Not so young lady. Mm. Happy 19th.
Thank you. My name is Kelly Betts, and today is my birthday.
41.
Is he going to keep talking throughout the whole thing?
Unbelievable.
Or, I mean, what's the deal here?
I thought the rule was speak when you're spoken to.
Then why did you speak?
Because you asked a question.
I wasn't looking at you, and it was rhetorical.
Well, you didn't make that clear.
I'm not talking to you now.
Well, you're looking at me.
I'm not talking to you. You, sir.
My name is Justin Dealey. I'm a reporter on the programme. I'm a man of the people. I also present a music programme at the weekend.
All right,
All round good guy /... Ladies, man.
This is not a chance for you to plug your own wares.
No, you asked me to simply say a few words about myself.
Listen, I get accused on the BBC Three Counties listeners page. There are two. You know there are two BBC Three Counties listeners page. One is written with the word
one
three.
Each. One for each listener.
One is written with the word three. Those are the guys that don't like me, and I'd love those guys to let me post on their page. They banned me. Another one is written with the number three.
But they're both listener pages.
Yeah. And the number three one is quite nice towards the show. But the words three one is quite cold towards the show. I just don't know who to believe.
Mm.
Don't know who to believe.
It's difficult to...
It's hard.
Mm.
Wasn't talking to you. Hello and welcome to my podcast. The best bits of the week crammed down one dark... whole. All right, don't tell nobody. But here's how BBC Stoke started their show on Monday.
Good morning. It is Monday, the 3rd of August. Hope you're well this morning. Yes, it is Charlotte and Lee for you at breakfast. Stuart is on his holidays.
In Crawley.
Obviously, where else would you go? It's been a busy weekend, hasn't it?
Yeah, have you been up to much of note?
I went to Leeds over the weekend and then yesterday got attacked by flying ants.
Here's how BBC Hereford and Worcester started their show on Monday.
How are you then? Monday already, so soon, my life. What's going on? Why have the weeks passed by so quickly? Did your heart skip a beat yesterday when you heard that news? Tributes are pouring in to singer and TV star Cilla Black, who's died at the age of 72. Still can't quite believe that. And also, could turning our villages into towns be the answer to meeting housing needs?
Here's how I started my show on Monday.
Keep dreaming about darling, ooh, ooh, my darling, you're so fine. Oh, oh, yeah. Don't know if words can say.
Are you doing the whole song?
But darling, I'll find a way to let you know what you meant to me.
Singing the whole song.
Guess it was meant to be. I'll hold you in my heart as life's most precious part. Whoa, darling, I dream about you off of my pretty girl, yeah.
I love the way you suffer my life with your
Stop
love, your
in my
precious
eyes while I'm
love.
Doing it.
Ooh. I was living like half a man.
Oh, good, it's still on.
Then I couldn't love, but now I can. You pick me up when I'm feeling sad, more so than I ever had. Gonna love you every single night. Yes, I will, 'cause I think you're too doggone out of sight. Oh, oh darling,
this is on
I dream about you often, my pretty girl, yeah. I love the way you soften my life with your love, your precious love.
Should I finish the nine?
Every night, oh darling, keep dreaming about my darling every night. Oh, oh, oh. No, if words can say, yes, I can.
Good.
But darling, I love you every single day. Oh, darling, I dream about you often, my pretty girl, yeah. I love the way you soften my life with your love, your precious love. Look at me. Oh, oh,
oh,
ooh.
So happy for the fade.
Every night, a cappella ending. There's another one.
Yep.
Not even started the show yet.
No.
I mean, incredible. Well, that was uncomfortable. Imagine the listener. Imagine being the Beach Boy though, and having to sing that every night to people they don't know. I was singing it to you, and you are my darling. Apostrophes. No, Gila. That'd be crazy. Okay, we're in. We're in.
Across Beds, Hearts and Bucks.
This is BBC Three Counties Radio.
Don't do it again.
It's automatic. I missed it again. It's automatic when I talk with old friends. A conversation. I don't know what the tune is.
Do I need to be in here for this?
And the hair was soft and long, and the beach was the place to go. Yeah. Yeah, I'm getting to suntan bodies, and there's plenty of those, a whole album of those.
Oh, great, I look forward to them.
And that's why I get fired a lot. As is this. Really touches. Zilla Black passed away, legend.
Yep.
Did you ever work with her, Just?
No, never. Never, unfortunately.
Scoins?
I once called her agent to try and get her on the show.
Okay.
On this show.
Great, great times. Betsy's?
No, but she was my password for a long time.
She was. I'm not even going to ask you, Matt.
I bought a record.
I have got some great stories about Scylla, which I'll tell you after the podcast.
Yeah.
She passed away, and it's very, very sad. We had lots of tributes come in to Scylla, showbiz legend. We just picked this. This is one of them. I'm not going to say the best. They were all the best. So surprise, surprise. It's a blind the data. And here's Scott's tribute to Scylla. Is this music to, I mean... It's Bohemian Rhapsody.
I don't know. Yeah.
I don't want to take in the mic. Hang on. No. What's this? Hang on. Here we go. No, that's from Star Wars. That's no you. Here we go. This is nice.
This is nice, yeah, lovely.
Let's get the email as he sent it to. Oh, I think I might have deleted it by mistake. Oh, well, that's awkward. Oh, where's he sent it? Oh, hang on a minute. Hang on. Just bear with me, Justin. Bear with me.
No worries. I'm sure these are very precious memories.
They are. It's a really nice email from Scott, of all people, which is unusual. Hang on. Hang on. 03459 455555. Kelly?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? You all right?
Yeah, you.
I'm just trying to find that email. Okay, it's from Scott. Memories of Scylla. And this is an appropriate song. You know.
She'll be laughing.
Why are you laughing?
No, she'll be laughing.
She'll be smiling down with a fag on, a glass of bubbly. I don't know if she smoked. I remember watching Memories of Scylla from Scott. I remember watching our Scylla, as I like to call her, on the television when I was younger. Most notably for her work on Blind Date, where she paved the way for the future great Paddy McGuinness. The great thing about Blind Date was when she said, here's our Graham with a quick reminder. When Graham, who we never saw, he was behind the scenes somewhere, would read out a short synopsis of each contestant, usually with a funny last line, lol. So yes, that was good. I also remember our Scylla in Surprise Surprise. Where she would surprise people with a long-lost sister or brother. I didn't know that was coming. Where she would surprise people with a long-lost sister or brother. Sometimes it would be sad. I didn't know the whistle was coming. That's what I'm laughing at. Sometimes it would be sad where a mum would have neglected her children through drug abuse. But later got clean and wanted a second chance. Thanks for the memories, Arcilla. You were a real fun gal. Miss you. Love, Scott. Scott, that was lovely. Do we know? Have we spoken to her before?
Yeah.
All right. Okay. I never remember if I've spoken to anybody else before. Hey, Jenny, it's great to speak to you again.
Right.
Yes.
Hello?
It's a loud TikTok you've got, isn't it? Is Stonehenge real? Can you hear me, Jenny?
Oh, hello!
I've been talking to you for about a minute.
I just wanted to say Cheddar Gorge was bigger than I expected.
Oh, what was it?
Yeah, it was much bigger. I was really shocked.
It's very rare, isn't it, Jenny, these days? You can go and you look at something and they're always smaller in real life.
They are, yeah, disappointing.
Isn't it, though?
It is,
especially with the internet and these dating apps.
Yeah, oh. Yeah.
Why did you go to Cheddar Gorge? Was it gorgeous?
Why did I go to Cheddar? Probably didn't know anything else to do.
Yeah, isn't it? Stonehenge, Stonehenge isn't real.
Oh.
It's a fake stone. The real Stonehenge blew down. So Cheddar Gorge was bigger.
Oh, yeah.
Have you ever been to America?
No.
Oh.
Is that no? Because it'll be smaller than I expected.
America is a lot smaller than you expected, Jenny. Thanks for calling.
All right.
How do you sleep with that TikTok?
Oh, doesn't bother me.
Oh, it's bothering me. It's doing my nut.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Oh, next time I phone, I'll put the phone somewhere else so you can't hear it. Oh, you don't like it.
Oh, it's too loud.
Oh. Ooh, you're very sensitive, aren't you?
I'm a very sensitive man, and I think you'd enjoy that.
It's probably because you have to get up early, Iain.
Yeah, isn't it? Jenny, nice to talk to you. See you later.
Bye.
Ta-ra. Here's some questions that I asked this week. Nice to see a little bit of bum crack, isn't it? You've never been murdered by an engineer. He is a really... Can we speed things up, guys?
You're the one slowing it down.
Whoa. Hey. I'm the driving force. Which is actually a great name for a car show. Driving Force. That is not a bad name for a car show.
With Jeremy Clarkson.
No.
It will be.
He's going to Netflix.
No.
Amazon.
He's gone. That's what I said.
Get it right, man.
I've got it right, man.
Get it right.
I've got it right, man.
What about this then? Driving force, okay? What, where you take fast cars and you drive them through gale force winds? Driving force.
Gale, and it's Gale from Coronation Street.
Yeah, who drives the car?
Gale.
Mate, we're on this.
This is awesome. Oh, when is this on?
Gale force. It's a sniper squad run by Gale from East End Coronation Street.
Get it right.
Yeah.
Don't correct him. Get it right, mate. Correct him.
Get it right.
Get it right, mate.
Boko Haram.
What's they got to do with anything?
He does say it in a funny way.
He just likes Boko Haram when I say it.
I don't
it.
Think he likes them.
No, but he likes it when I say it.
I don't think he... Well, I know, but
it's
I
like
mean...
It's like a tickle in his belly.
I just think those guys are so overrated.
Yeah. Their second album didn't really stack up.
Yeah, we're doing a clever joke about music and terrorism. Where were we, Kelly? Please... Gale Force. So here's a clip from Gale Force.
Nope, but here's Wednesday's show in a sweet, sweet nutshell.
Is Gale Force involved in any way whatsoever?
No.
Okay. Now, Kelly Betts, not in any way suggesting that you take drugs or that you smuggle drugs or that you've got friends in prison or that if you did have friends in prison, you would smuggle drugs into them. Mm-hmm. So let's just that's parked to one side.
That's good to know.
That's in the car park.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Got the keys.
Yeah.
They're not zapper keys. They're keys you've actually... The keys to my car, you've actually got to put them in the slot. Not zappers.
The engine.
Huh? Mm? The key, the door key.
Yeah. You put in the...
How is the door key the same as the engine key? What's that all about?
Yeah.
Little bit of stand-up for you there, guys.
I've never even thought about
What's
that.
What's that all about? I want to be a stand-up comedian, and all I'm going to do is just go, how come the door keys on a car are the same as the engine keys? What's that all about?
What else would you say?
That's it. Very short act. Just a tryout. Just an open spot. That's all I've got. But it's good. Anyway. A junkie... Oh, already we're judging this poor crook. Tried to smuggle... Right, he smuggled... Okay, where are you going to insert drugs to smuggle them into prison? That's obvious. Go.
Your bottom.
Correct. Where would you smuggle your drugs? Lockers?
The same place.
Kelly's bottom?
Yes. Same
it's
place.
It's always there.
Very busy up there, I believe.
It really is.
A lot of traffic.
That's just rude.
True, then.
Okay. But how
what
would
you... are you suggesting?
Steady. How would you... And again, young ears. Young ears... Please.
I am young.
What would you... What? Oh, this is real. I wish I hadn't started this conversation. What would you use? Would you just put them in au naturel? Or would you use a device? Protective sheath of some kind to insert. To maintain the integrity of the chemicals of the drugs.
I do have an answer, but why?
Okay. I will tell you why.
Okay.
But why are you being hesitant about that?
It's just a weird question to ask somebody.
Okay. It is a weird question to ask. You're right. Thank you for calling me up on that. A junkie tried to smuggle drugs into jail in a Kinder Surprise egg.
Oh.
They called it a pot. That's not a pot. Well, maybe it was pot.
Oh, no. Inside the egg is that little yellow pot.
Yeah, I know. I've got kids, but that's not a pot. I wouldn't call that a pot. I'd call that... What would you call that? The yellow thing inside a Kinder.
What's it all about?
What's it... Huh?
Is that not what you're saying is?
It's my catchphrase.
Yeah, that's...
But that's not... I wouldn't then go... My second gig didn't go so well as a stand-up because after the heady rush of me saying... What was my first gag that I ever did live on stage?
The one you just spoke about?
Yeah, yeah.
How is the door key the same as the engine?
What's that all about? The next gig, I thought, wow, okay. So I did the dorky gag, went beautifully. And then I did the, what do you call the little yellow thing inside a Kinder egg? What's that all about? Silence. Mm. Silence. Mm. Now, either it was so profound that they couldn't stop thinking about it, or it was rubbish. I'm gonna suggest it was the former.
Mm-hmm.
There is a possibility it was the latter.
Yep.
Lewis Coombs, 27... hid 33 heroin substitute tablets in the egg's plastic toy container before handing himself in to finish off a sentence. Oh, so he got out of prison, shoved drugs up his bum, then went and said, I'll go back to prison now. I don't mind. What's that all about? Boom, I got the audience back. It was a great night. It was a great gig. Didn't get paid for it. He was rumbled.
What's that all about?
He was rumbled. I bet he was. Oh, no, there's more. When he began to behave erratically. Yeah, you've got a Kinder. I'm going to call it a pot, although I'd never say that. Well, call it the egg. It's the egg.
The yellow container. The thing.
Yeah. What?
The thing. Let's just call it the thing.
03459 455 555. What do you call the toys in the Kinder? What I'm trying to suggest is that is a big thing to put up your bum. Whoa. Here we go.
Hi, my name is Quincy. I'm a little frisky. I like to cut up bodies, then have sex. New York, you'll find me with a lady lay beside me. Is she dead? I'll check her leg.
I can't remember the rest of it. There she is. Is she dead?
Oh, yeah.
I'll check her leg, you see.
Yeah, he's doing it.
Yeah. I can't remember the rest of it.
On a yacht you'll find me with a lady lay beside me. Is she dead? I'll check her leg. Hi, my name is Quincy.
There's more though, and if anyone's got the proper lyrics, then I really do wish you the very best of luck with that. You still here?
Well, I was listening to that.
No, it's done now.
Okay.
Beep. There's your edit point. Welcome back. So this gentleman wants to go to Calais to speak to the migrants to tell them why they shouldn't come to England and they should go back to the Sudan and Uganda and all these places that some of them are fleeing persecution from and war from. Not all of them, but some of them. By the way, this chap comes from, I think, Uganda, has been over here for 10 years. Have a listen.
First of all, my main objective is allied intervention in other nations here before, and also to create, I would like to create that forum whereby these people can engage with the government. There can be a dialogue at the moment in at Calais, because what's happening is that you see the police and the dogs standing over the other side, and these people standing on this side.
You know that there's hardly any public health care in Somalia, don't you?
There is.
There's hardly any public health care in Somalia. They spend all their money, the significant amount of their money, on the military.
There is public health care.
There's 429 midwives in Somalia. That makes one midwife per 1,000 live births. It's not great, is it? It's not great.
But what we need to know,
90, according to the World Health Organization, I'm just getting these from Wikipedia, 97.9%, nearly all of Somalia's women and girls underwent female circumcision. You could understand why people wouldn't want to stay there. And it could be suggested, Mike, that you go in to speak to people who've been subject to or are fleeing female circumcision and saying, guys, your country's got oil. You just need to change your mentality. It could be perceived as being a little bit patronising, couldn't it?
One can take it that way. And obviously that would be somebody's perception, which you can't deny them. But the main issue here is, these young men and women are very intelligent people. For somebody to be able to travel from Africa to here, to Calais, you know, you have to be really intelligent. Now, these are people who've gone through education, they've gone through university, some of them have got masters, you know, of which people their developing countries need them, you know. So this is some of the messages.
Maybe they don't want to have female circumcision done.
Well, there are other things that, you know, we can't
tough.
Really...
It's tough, isn't it?
Tough. But, you know,
we need to put culture
into consideration as well. I mean, Iain, when you're in Britain, we've got, you know, culture here, of which when an African comes in, has to, you know, to abide by, you got saying. And when you go in Africa, they've got their own culture.
Yeah. Whereabouts are you from, Mike?
Where am I from? I'm from Uganda.
Okay. When did you come over here?
I've been here for over 10 years.
Why don't you go back? Doesn't Uganda need you? Doesn't Ugandan culture need you?
There's what we call globalization. Now, localization is global and then localization. What I'm doing here...
I've literally no idea what that means. I'm looking forward to hearing it.
Yeah. I'm going to define it. Globalization is basically from global and then localization.
You just said it. You just said the word again. That's not definition. That's just saying the word again. What I'm saying is, why is it all right for you to be over here and not those people to be over here? And in the great scheme of things, Mike, I'm sure your heart's in the right place, but you going over there and saying, well, do you know what? It's not quite as good as you think it is. Well, that's just simply not true. It's significantly better. A lot of these people are fleeing. There are a few that are fleeing because they think that maybe they're going to get a free council house and some benefits. OK. But a significant majority of those people are fleeing from war, from religious persecution, from potential death, from female circumcision. So whatever they get here is better than what they had there, isn't it?
That's very true. But also, we know that there are other countries in Africa where these people can go. Why is it that the African leaders are not, you know, able to come out and say something and protest their people?
Why did you come here?
For example, we had a lot of... so many of them have died in the ocean.
Yeah.
Have you ever had anything from the African, for example, the African Union saying anything?
About what? Say anything from the African Union about what?
About the people smugglers, about these people.
Yeah, that's how desperate they are. Why did you come here, Mike? Did you want a better life?
No. It wasn't about better life.
So why did you come here? What was better about here than Uganda?
I think, Iain, I don't know if you've travelled to other countries. It's not that
Why did you move here?
There's freedom of movement wherever. If you wanna, you can say, I wanna go to, you know, such a country. And
why did you? Why did you move here?
It was to study.
What was wrong with the studying in Uganda?
I'd already attained a degree there, and when I came here, I'd come for my master's. Now, I've already attained a degree in Uganda. I'm coming here for my master's from a different...
Why couldn't you do your master's in Uganda?
It's just to have a different texture, you know, taste of university.
OK, well, you've got your master's. Why don't you go back?
This is what I was bringing to you, that glow localization. Right now in my community, I'm doing a lot of work in my community where I live, in Mount Cairns, and, you know...
Go and do the work back... I'm going to say, and it's going to make me sound like a massive racist, go and do your work back home in Uganda. You see where I'm going, don't you, Mike?
No. I know where you're going to. And I know. Well, this is what I'm trying to bring to you, that there's what we call glow localization. If I go back to Uganda, I'm doing a great job here within my community, supporting young refugees, asylum seekers, you know, in my community. You can say. So before I go back, and this is...
But there's loads of people doing that over here. How many are doing it in Uganda?
But remember that we're different, you know. You may be doing it. For example, if I come to the radio, I may not be able to talk the way you're talking. You've got different skills. I've got different skills. So my approach might be different, you know. I may be able to attain the objective through my approach. Maybe I've got people skills. I've got, you know, communication skills. All those skills are key. You know, so global localization is starting.
Okay,
local,
so you see me, right? My name's Akeem, right? And I'm hiding behind a fence in Calais, and I'm thinking, right, tonight at midnight, we're gonna dash through the tunnel, we're gonna make it to the UK. And you see me, and you come over. What's the top three things you're gonna say to me, Mike, to persuade me that I should actually go back to the Sudan?
Well, actually, it would be a direct question.
Go.
Do you know what's beyond this fence? You know,
I don't know what's beyond there, but it's got to be worse. It's got to be better than being starved, being persecuted, having no public health, and my wife having her watsits cut.
And then that's due to lack of information. This is where the problem is, because our people are lacking information.
No, that's what happens.
Yeah. So I'll have to educate these people that actually, you know, it can take even 10 years to settle in the UK.
Right.
You know,
will my wife's watsits be cut against her will in England? No, we're coming.
Can I go to the second question?
What
I'm
going
to say to these people?
Yes.
The second one will be asking them if somebody, you know, the message they can give to the people back home. you know. They've gone through a lot of trauma.
There's a what? A message?
Yeah, what message would you give to your people back home? Because that's a key. You're going through a lot at this time, at this point.
Yeah.
And would you encourage another person to go through illegal smuggling?
I'd say we've made it this far, and my wife has not had to endure female circumcision. So far, we're winning. Third question.
Iain, can I first say that...
You've got 30 seconds.
Female circumcision is not the key. I think...
Hang on a minute. When was the last time you had your female parts circumcised? Exactly. What do you mean it's not the key? It's 97.9% of the population getting it done.
I think, Iain, there are bigger key issues that are forcing this report to...
Mike, you you're right. And, of course, there are bigger key issues. But, you know, to some people... And I've got to end it then, Mike, because I'm late for the travel. But, I wish you the very best of luck. Your heart's in the right place, I make up. But I also make up that maybe your outlook is perhaps a little naive. I appreciate your time, Mike. Here's a report on turd. That's not a sentence.
No.
Justin, you try. We're all going to go around the room.
Yeah.
And we're going to see who gets... We're going to audition for the part of who does this line, OK?
OK.
So, you've heard mine. Justin, can I hear yours?
OK, yes. Mine goes like this. Here's a report on turd.
OK. Interesting turn of phrase. Kels?
You're about to hear a report.
No. I'm sorry. Okay. I'm really sorry. This isn't a blooming Whose Line Is It Anyway. We're not the Comedy or Saw Players. You're not Richard Ranch at the piano, mate. OK. Read the script. The power is in the words.
Here's a report on turd.
You can't read. But Scoins, I'm going to just skip you for a moment. Mm. I just got a feeling. Lockers.
You see, when you put me on the spot like this...
It's not on the spot.
All right,
mate.
Okay.
You knew it was coming.
Yeah, yeah, okay,
here we go. We've gone around the room. You knew it was coming.
Okay, here we go. Here's a report on turd.
That's actually good.
Yeah, it was all right, but Scoinsy, right. I've got a special feeling, a real special vibe that this could be it.
Here's a report on turd.
You've got the gig. Let's have it, Scoins. Scoins, away you go.
Here's a report on turd.
Oh, that's beautiful.
That was beautiful. Come on, I knew it. That was beautiful. Beautiful. That was great. Come
it's
on.
It's 6 o'clock.
Sorry?
I'm just doing my rest of my audition tape.
Don't milk it, mate.
No.
No, seriously, don't milk it. Put it away.
Is that what you do at 6 o'clock? Is it like a daily ritual?
Yeah.
Wow. That's how he talks to his wife.
It's 6 o'clock.
It's 6 o'clock. Breakfast. It's breakfast time. Would you like some Honey Nut Loops? Am I right? I'm not wrong.
You're not wrong, no.
It's... It's 9:30 p.m. It's bunky bunky time. Would you like me to pleasure you? You've been pleasured by Paul Scoins. Same time, same place. Next year.
AKA the Destroyer.
Oh, Paul, why are you crying? Oh, mate, is it because we're bullying you mercilessly?
Because it's true?
It brings back bad memories.
Happy memories.
So, the Turdinator, you've taken this one to the streets, Dills.
Yes, this man who is incensed at dog walkers not cleaning up after their dogs, hiding around in bushes in camouflage clothing.
That's weird, isn't it?
It's weird, jumping out of people, naming and shaming them on Facebook. Has he gone too far? I've been talking to dog walkers this morning. Gets a little bit tense towards the end. Here's what happened.
Can I just say, right,
yeah.
You don't need to tell us that anymore, because pretty much every Vox you've done since we've been in Dunstable has got a little bit tense towards the end.
Yeah, it's a tense place to be. Steve, you've got three beautiful dogs. You've actually got a doggy bag in your hand right now. Enjoy your breakfast, guys. What do you think about the Turdinator? Is he going too far?
No, not at all. There's too many people that don't clear up their from their dogs, no matter where you go.
Yeah.
You know, it's... Well, you've only got to walk around here. It's all over the place.
So even if the Turdinator jumped out at somebody and he scared them by doing that, you'd have no sympathy for that person?
It depends, isn't it? It depends what you mean by scaring them. You know,
well, if somebody jumped out from a tree in camouflage clothing, you know, that is quite scary.
If it's done in a bit of jest, then it's not so bad, is it? If it's done with a bit of malice and aggression, then it's a step too far. I mean, I've told several people myself, you know, it's unacceptable, isn't it? Why would you have a dog that, you know, why... there's lots of families here in the evenings, isn't there?
Yeah.
You know, most evenings it's full of families out here. They'd want to be setting up a picnic and there's dog's mess everywhere.
I was going to say, just lastly, I'm glad you've kind of led me onto this. You don't jump out of bushes in camouflage clothing.
No.
You simply talk to people. When you have said, look, what are you doing? Why are you not clearing up after your dog? What happened next?
You normally get a mouthful of abuse and get told to mind your own business.
And then what?
I'll just give them a piece of my mind and walk away.
Has it ever got violent?
No.
Fair play to you. Thanks for your time.
No, thank you. No worries.
Sir, the Turdinator, is he going too far? What do you think?
No, not really. If people shouldn't do that. They know the rules. You've got kids and babies running over parks. They can get, if they touch any of that stuff, they can go blind. And I think if that's what he does, as long as he's not hurting people, but if he's just getting people to clear up the mess, then I think he's 100% right.
I'd like to see him round here, you know.
If he jumped out of you...
I think he's a peeping Tom. I'd do him. I'd knock him out.
Well, he probably wouldn't jump out at you, to be fair, because you clean up after your dog. So he wouldn't be looking for you.
Well, that's all right then, isn't it?
But if he did jump out at you, you'd knock him out.
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks for your time, sir.
All right, mate.
Thank you. Cheers.
Two things. Firstly, we do not condone violence of any sort. Secondly, Matt, would you like to ask Justin the question that you asked Kelly Betts there?
Did that man bleep himself?
Yeah, he actually asked that. The first man who obviously swore, I'm guessing he said the S word, there was a bleep. Done, Justin, for putting that in. Lockwood actually, is this right, Kelly? He actually asked you seriously if the man bleeped himself.
He said, how did he bleep himself?
Wow.
This is what we're dealing with.
Mate,
he's
seriously
got the producer hat on today.
That's scary.
Isn't it? Should we phone up and bully Kath?
Yes.
Okay, I need to drag you down there. Where are we next?
Here's Matt being a plum.
Okay. Do you want to do it?
Here's Matt being a plum.
Texting and Facebook spell the N for birthday cards. Waking up to a pile of cards from family and friends. So it's the boring bit. You got presents, you got cards. Well, you kind of open the cards first to make the present bit last a bit longer. If you do the cards afterwards, you're not bothered because you've already got your scale electric or your DVD or your puppy.
Cards are dinner. Presents, dessert.
No,
watching people open cards, but open it upside down so the money falls out and then just passing the card along.
People don't put money in cards anything further, Father. Presents are starter and main. Cards are dessert and you can't eat it because you're stuffed.
No, cards are like an amuse-bouche. That's what they are. They're just, you know...
They're a what, sorry?
An amuse-bouche. They just get you into it.
Just
what?
Sorry, one more time there.
An amuse-bouche.
Is that a bush that's having a good time?
No, it's never an amuse-bouche.
Never tickle a bush without permission from the bush's owner.
I go to restaurants where you can have an amuse-bouche.
You've never been to a restaurant where you can have an amuse-bouche?
I have, yes.
You haven't?
Yeah, I have.
Well, you haven't. Because they don't exist.
What, an amuse-bouche does not exist?
Do you mean an amuse-bouche?
No, it's not an amuse-bouche.
It's a bouche.
Is it?
Yes.
Oh, well, it's the same thing.
Right, no one say anything. Oh, I don't know how to make it work. Oh, yes, I did that.
Sorry, I can't get to the phone.
Oh,
line.
What an absolute bum.
And I'll call you back as soon as I can. Thanks, bye.
At the tone, please record your message.
She sounded
when you
like
have
normal.
Finished, you may hang up or press 1 to change your message.
Matt, leave her a message.
Hello, Kath. Hope you're well. Hope you had a nice holiday. It'll be nice to have you back. Bye.
Right, we'll leave.
Wow.
Okay, look, it's going. Do you want to audition for the person who leaves the message on Kath's phone?
Yeah, sure.
Go.
Hey, Catherine. Hope you're all right. Saw some lovely pictures from your holidays. Wonderful times. Really looking forward to having you back next week, and we'll get the decaffeinated coffee on. Bye for now.
That was great. Scoins really is blank a blinder. Justin, do you want to have a go auditioning for the person that leaves a message on Kath's phone?
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Why not? Hi, Kath. It's the J-Dog here. just to let you know that in the 2 weeks since we last saw each other, I'm still wearing vest tops. I know that you've been thinking about me. I'll see you on Monday. And please, heads up on this one, please can you bring your instrument with you? Thank you.
Oh, little tease.
Euphemism.
Is it so she can cup you again?
Yes.
Kels?
Hey, baby.
Oh.
I miss you.
Hey.
I can't wait for you to come back.
Oh, yeah.
I've missed having you by my side.
I've
missed checking you out when you walk past. And I've missed that great rack.
Oh, that was a little bit...
call me.
A little bit sleazy at the end there. Okay, Friday. That's your podcast, guys. Really hope you enjoyed it. All donations gratefully appreciated.
Can you just say, here's some bits from Friday?
I'm not going to do
Thursday.
That.
Thursday.
No.
Please just say.
Not going to do that.
Just.
No.
There's some stuff from Thursday. Some mixture of things.
No.
It's quite good.
No. That's not happening.
Thank you, player.
No.
Theoretically, though, if there were bits from Friday and Thursday, how would you introduce them?
Here are some bits from Thursday. I hope you enjoy.
Well, I'm wondering, look, I was up all night.
Hey, get in there, geezer. Scoins has just come in. Scoins, you're going to love this. David, say to Scoins exactly what you said to me.
I was up all night, mate.
Hey! Come on. Oh, can't sing that one, no. Get in there, David, my son. Get in there, David, my son. He was up all night. Get in there, David,
anything
my son.
Less than 2 hours ain't worth it.
Yay, David! Ooh, I'm David. I'm Mr. Lover. Oh, romantic.
Telefantastic.
Hey, oh. Were you plugged in my thoughts last night?
Yes, I was plugged in your thoughts last night. Could you tell? Because I was told, the guy that sold me the thought plugger in her said that the person whose thoughts I plugged into wouldn't actually notice. Are you telling me you noticed?
Bloody right, didn't I? Well, how come you mentioned helium this morning?
Sorry?
How come you mentioned helium?
Well, that's the name of the band that we didn't play.
Well, look, when I was a teenager, I went along to a mate's party and my mate Liam came along with me. As we come in through the front door, right... The guy says, well, who's he? I said, he Liam. He's
right.
A gas.
Yeah.
Helium.
Then what? What? With the balloons? I'm confused.
Right, OK. We step inside the front door and the guy there inside...
Yeah, so whose party... Right, hang on a minute. Let's back off. Back up a bit, because I'm getting confused. Whose party was it?
Oh, Jesus.
OK, so it was Jesus' party.
Yeah.
A Christian gathering.
Might have been Christmas.
Been John.
Was it Jesus?
Yeah, well, you never know.
Okay.
It was a bit busy there.
So you went to... Was it? So it was a busy party hosted by Jesus. You went there with your friend Liam. What, and Jesus didn't know Liam? He only knew you?
No, so he says, well, who's he? So
why did you take someone that he... Why did you take someone to the party that hadn't been invited? Bit rude.
Doesn't everybody sometime?
No, never. You take someone to a party who's not invited. Yeah, no. If you're five, you'll have this, Scoins. Not if you're five. If you're the parent of a five-year-old and you want to take a younger sibling to the party, you always say, is it right if I bring child number two? And they quite often say, no, that's fair enough. They do say that, and that's fair enough. Mm. They often say, sometimes they say, yes. And sometimes they say, yes, but we've only got enough food. Are they OK to share? Beautiful. Fantastic. So for you to bring this guy... And sorry, what was your friend's name?
Liam.
For you to take Liam to Jesus' party, I mean, supposing he didn't have enough Fanta.
Gee, well, that's a real problem, isn't it? But, you know, you get party songs, don't you?
You do certainly get party songs. Yes, you do.
Yeah,
here's my favourite party song. You know what happiness is to you. Because I'm happy. Come along if you like that's what you wanna do. Because I'm happy. Come along if you feel like happiness on the roof. Because I'm happy. Come along if you feel like that's what is the truth. Because I'm happy. Come along if you feel like happiness is the truth. Acapulco, here we go. Come along if you feel like that's what you wanna do.
Now,
why did you... Hang on a minute, David, excuse me.
I'm dancing, man.
I'm asking. Why did you... You were singing an alternate line to me, and then when we went Acapulco, you started singing the same line as me, Scoins.
Yeah.
Why would you do that? Let's try again. Shut up, David. This is important stuff. We've got the most listeners we've ever had. Let's see how many we can lose. Okay. That's you now. No, I'm singing the
bit. Oh, no, I have to do the be happy. I'm happy.
You have to do the be happy.
Okay, fine.
Happy. If you feel like that's what you want to do. Come happy. Come along if you feel like happy inside of you. Because I'm happy. Come along if you feel like that's what you want to do.
Because I'm happy.
Come along if you feel like that's what you want to do.
Because I'm happy.
Come along if you feel like happiness is true.
Because I'm happy.
Come along if you feel like that's what you want to do.
Because I'm happy.
Come along if you feel like a room without a roof. Yeah! There we did it. Oh. David, great call, mate. Thanks for calling. Bye-bye. I forgot Kelly Betts' birthday.
You're welcome.
That happens.
It's fine.
It is. Well, now, you're saying the it's fine in the it's not really fine
no,
way.
No, really, it's so you're doing fine. That
thing,
I don't mind.
You're doing that thing that chicks do. And that's getting me hot. But you're also doing the other thing that chicks do.
What's
give
that?
Me the cold shoulder. No. But you're also doing a third thing that chicks do. Looking mighty fine. The fourth let's just skip through to the 19th thing you're doing that chicks do is that thing when you go, with something obviously isn't all right.
No, but it actually really is.
And you go, are you all right? Yeah, I'm fine. Right, well, I know you're not fine, so what's... No, I'm fine.
Happy birthday, Kelly.
Thanks.
I love mushy peas.
Was that the voice of God? What happened there?
Thanks.
I've got literally no idea what happened there.
Where did that even come from? No, but seriously, it's fine.
Oh, no, you said no, but seriously at the start of that sentence.
No, but seriously.
Oh, Kelly.
It's...
What can I do? I've got cash. Do you want a tenner? Is that tight? 20 quid?
Keep going.
I'm going to actually back away from the 20. That's more than I would spend on a birthday present. For even my wife. So if you want me... I mean, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. Scorings, come in, because this involves you, mate, actually.
Scorings, do you
want to
go in? This involves you, he
said. It's all right, he can talk. He's doing a little bit of pre-production, that's fine. What I am prepared to do, Kelly, as I forgot your birthday, is I'm going to say, for today only, Paul Scorings is your slave. Don't worry, it's fine. Interpret that... Any way you want.
And you're the boss.
Yeah.
So that this is actually happening.
This is actually happening. Paul Scorings is your slave for the day.
Can you, Scorings?
Can you?
Say...
Can ye, West? Hello, my name's... I'm an American rap star, and I really want to go to Reading. Can you tell me how to get there? Can ye, West? And before you go and slave away for Kelly Betts...
Yeah, she's not giving me anything else to do.
Give him something, Kelly. Give him a bone.
Can you speak to Dave Luton? He's on Fader 2.
Oh, flip it, heck. This is going to be tough. I'm with you, brother.
I didn't sign up for this. No. Morning, David.
Oh, good morning. Who's that? That's not... Hello? Oh, here... Flipping it. Oh, jeez. Talk to yourself on this road, David.
Hello.
Oh, are you up, Paul? Yeah, I know it is now.
Oh. Am I that obvious?
Oh, God. But don't get like him, Paul. You know what I mean?
How do you mean?
Well, what do you mean? How do I mean?
Well, how do you mean?
Well, I'm going to talk to him, and he goes off. One of his tantrums again.
No, it's just a scheduled break.
No, yeah, he's always got a break, pal, you know what I mean?
He'll give you a break.
Who, you?
No.
You haven't got the guts to come to the Leicester Arms for a pop quiz.
Hey, my mate Matt.
It's disgusting.
Where's Matt? Have I won? Yes, that's me. Yeah. Yes. God. I've only come on here to wish Kelly a happy birthday. Are you real? Yes. Oh, dear. Why don't you get Justin on as well? What are you beefing on about? Justin. Just shut it, pal. Yeah, shut it. Oonga, 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 shanga, oonga, oonga, oonga. Oh, dear, oh, pray. Are you real? Yeah, I've done a little garden. Have I won? Yes.
It's disgusting.
I like the mushy peas. Kelly, can you come on? What are you beefing on about? Him. With your slackers. Oh, dear, I pray. Just shut it, pal. Can you get Matt on here, please?
At least you haven't got the guts to come to the Leicester Arms for a pot, please.
Oh, dear.
Start with my youngster.
Hello?
Hello, Iain.
Hello, Andy.
Yes. I just phoned up because I wanted to wish Kelly a happy birthday.
Oh, for crying out bums. What are you... This is not the phone up and wish happy birthday to Kelly show, Andrew. That's what you got for us, Kev.
I just rang up to wish Kelly a happy birthday.
Oh, for... No. No. Now, why have we got... I can see the switchboard now in these new studios, and the phones are busier than they've ever been. Richard, what do you want?
I'm lying the phone up as I wish Kelly a happy birthday.
Oh, for goodness.
Put me through to him. Go on.
Go on. Put you through to who?
Iain.
OK, I'll put you through now. The line's going to go dead, then the next thing you're going to hear is Iain, OK?
Go on, then.
OK, let's go to line three. It's Richard. Morning, Richard.
Hello there, mate. Long time no speak. I
just it, though?
I wish Kelly a happy birthday.
Oh, that's a lovely surprise. No, go away! For crying out loud. 03-459-455-555 is the telephone number. But not if you want to phone up and say hello to Kelly. Sorry, Kels.
No, it's fine.
No, it's not fine. It's out of order. It's ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh. Do you know what that means?
Yeah.
What?
Out of order.
Yeah.
Hey, Alan's anyway, on the line.
I've spoken to Alan. Alan,
no, you haven't.
Alan, have I spoken to you?
No, you haven't, no.
Oh, I'm so sorry, mate. It's just been callers winding me up this morning, and so are my in inverted commas.
Oh, really? What they wind you team. Up
at? What have you, just keep... They keep banging on, because it's Kelly's 19th, Alan. I don't even listen to the show. But they keep phoning up saying, oh, I want to say happy birthday to Kelly. Oh, I want to say happy birthday to
really?
Kelly. Oh,
okay, do
you want... No, you know what? I do not want callers phoning up to wish Kelly happy birthday. Anyway, Alan, what have you called him for, mate?
I just want to say, happy birthday, happy birthday to Kelly. That's what I want to say.
I'm furious right now.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Why don't you sing along with me, then? Sing along with me. Sing along with me, then.
I'm too angry to sing.
After two, one, two. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Haven't you got the balls? Or can't you sing?
What we're doing is I'm keeping you on the line because we've got a new computer system that can locate your whereabouts, like in those films in the 1990s involving the FBI.
Tell me where I am.
Letchworth.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, let's just see how many people ring
up. And it's honing, or homing, I'm not sure which, it's honing and homing in on your exact location. And as soon
Where is my exact location?
Letchworth. And as soon as I have as soon as I have the coordinates, I'm going to come round there.
Good.
You won't be saying that when I...
I will be. Together, then.
I'm not singing
sing
that...
Together.
Sing what?
Oh, can't you sing? After two, one, two. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Don't you see?
You make me want to puke.
Would you like a quick game of rock, scissors and paper?
No, thank you.
OK, so we're going to count to three and then you draw, OK? One, two, three. What you got?
Scissors.
Oh, mate, I got rock. I smashed a scissor.
Yeah, well, you didn't make your choice.
All right, we'll do it at the same time.
That doesn't count.
We'll do it at the same
time.
All right, mate. All right. Put the gun down. Put the gun down. One, two, three. What you got?
Rock.
Oh, mate, I got paper. Last one.
You're just a cheat. You don't even mention what you've got.
You're just a bad loser. I'll tell you what then. We'll swap it around. Go on then. You do the counting. Away you go.
Now you give your right. Arsenal first. And
you can do the counting. Go on.
One, two, three.
What you got?
No.
What you got?
I'm not giving mine first. That's for sure.
Okay. Well, I'm going to show the team what I've got. Okay. I'm showing them something. Right. What have you got?
Mush.
Yeah, tell me about it. What will I get for Christmas for an indoor? I mean, he's not got the best singing voice in the world, but
it's the message. Don't
give me your... Anyway, so he's getting all the props now. We should have been playing this last week.
Absolutely.
We should have been playing this. This is exactly the example. We should have been playing that last week and laughing about that last week and saying, oh, let's get George Cole on the phone and see if he can talk to us about that. And we didn't. And I'm going to regret that forever. Cilla Black, all the big tributes after she died. We have decided that we're going to start celebrating heritage legends, old people, while they're still alive.
Yeah.
And you came up with the idea, Gerry Marsden, today. Yeah,
absolutely. I mean, Gerry Marsden, absolute legend. So we've got a little package here about Gerry. Also on the streets this morning, talking to people about him. And as you say, celebrating this great man's life. Perspectives from right the way across the world coming up here as well. Here's what happened.
Forget Chris Evans, Rupert Grint and Prince Harry. Gerry Marsden is the UK's favourite ginger. His first three songs went straight to number one. Not even the Beatles did that. How do you do it? I like it. And this, a football anthem. This feat was not matched for 21 years when fellow Scousers Frankie Goes to Hollywood enjoyed the same success. He still tours up and down the country, thrilling audiences wherever he goes. In October, he's performing in Stevenage. And just the mention of his name on the streets today brought smiles and emotion. How would you describe Gerry Marsden?
Absolute player.
Appreciate your time. When I mentioned the name Gerry to you straight away, you smiled, didn't you?
Oh, yes. That's my sort of music.
We're celebrating Gerry Marsden today. It's the right thing to do, isn't it?
Yeah, of course. As far as I'm aware, he's a lovely man.
We always celebrate people when they've died, don't we? And that's the wrong thing. We should be celebrating these people every single day.
Yeah, I mean, why not? You know, everyone's got a right to be celebrated, whether alive or dead.
Yeah. Let's get the Zimbabwe perspective. Gerry Marsden, in one word, sir.
Legend.
Really means that much to you?
Yes, it does. It means somebody who has done something great for the people.
And he's certainly done that. It's a great Zimbabwe perspective. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Come on, sir. And you'll never walk...
again.
Oh, that's a different version. All right, mate, thanks very much.
No problem.
Gerry Marsden, MBE, one of the nicest men in showbiz. We salute you, sir. Hashtag legend.
What you've done there... We'll come up with a title for this. That was brilliant. It's one of the
thank
best
you,
things
thank you.
That's called doing a pre-gambo.
Yeah.
A pre-gambaccini. You're getting in there before they pass away.
Yep.
This is going to be a regular feature.
Absolutely.
We'll come up with a catchy name. I love it. I'm off for 2 weeks. I'm going to be in my house. I'm not going away anywhere, burglars. I'm going to be at home for 2 weeks just watching Netflix. We're going to go down a wet, tight crack.
Yep. Looking forward to that.
We're not even bothering with an innuendo, just being obscene.
I mean, that is actually... Correct.
Yeah, we're gonna rubber up and go down. You're gonna go first into a wet, tight crack, and then if you can fit in, then I'm gonna see if I can squeeze through the gash in the ground. That's what you call it.
It's a fact.
It's a fact, mate. It's not fiction. Thank you, Justin, for the support there. Justin's genuinely, by the way, genuinely upset that he's not coming. Portholing. That's where you break into ships. He's not coming potholing with us. And I couldn't make up on the spot a good reason as to why we didn't invite him, so maybe you'd like to.
Well, the offer was open about
before you start, can
a
you
year
look,
ago.
Look at me first?
No, yeah. The offer was made.
Okay, you're looking at me? Right, okay. I'm all ears. Fire away.
It was pitched out as an idea to the team at least a year ago.
It's not a business opportunity, mate. You're not in Dragon's Den. Pitched out as an idea.
It was pitched out as an idea. It was a rough around the edges pitch, but it was there. And a number of people expressed an interest. You did, and Kelly did as well.
Mm-hmm. So what happened?
Yeah.
Well, I got to the point where I was like, well, we need to do something.
And so then you just told Iain about it?
Well, no, it was similar to
you
that.
You want him all to yourself in a dark hole?
No.
Guys, listen, I've got to...
Basically, this...
He wants to love you.
I tell you what we're going to do, guys. Listen, you need to sort this out. Can we put this in the podcast? I've been asked to record something, and I can't be bothered to email it to them. So I thought we could all do this. Where are they?
Is this for an advert?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, it's for a band. Okay. Pat wants me to introduce his band. So, do you mind if I do it? And we put it in the podcast, and then Pat, you can pull it off?
Go for it.
Okay. Hi, this is Iain Lee. Welcome to Wherever You Are. You're about to witness two of the finest musicians known to humankind. Get ready. Calm down. Get excited. Drink some booze. Maybe do something a bit naughty. Then drink some more booze. Then sit down, stand up and touch yourselves. And please welcome Pat and Lindsay, also known as... Don't Fret!
That was good.
Thank you.
That was good.
That's great. Why you get the gigs.
Great name.
That's
thank
why you,
you
get the gigs.
Pat and Lindsay, don't fret. Mm. Fret as in fretting on a guitar keyboard, yeah. And also fretting as, oh my God, my wife's seeing another man and I'm a heroin abuser. That kind of stuff. Yeah. That's the podcast, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Classic band, Steely.
Yep.
You've been listening to, let's do it as though it's the end of Dad's Army. We haven't got the visuals, so you're going to have to do your names. You've been listening to me, Iain Lee, waves to the audience.
Me, Lockers.
Boo.
Me, Stoinhead.
Me, Kelly Betts.
Hey! And me, Justin Dealey, aka J-Doll.
Well done, guys. Great, guys. Several hours later.
Woo! That was good.
Jeez. I got the last one in. Stop it now. Bum.
Thanks for listening to this free download from BBC Three Counties Radio, your local radio station for Beds, Hearts and Bucks, on FM, AM, digital radio and online at bbc.co.uk/threecounties.